हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट टाइम पर हमने लॉज ऑफ फ्लोटेशन पढ़े थे। लॉज ऑफ फ्लोटेशन में हमने तीन पॉइंट्स लिए थे कि व्हेन द वेट ऑफ द बॉडी इज ग्रेटर देन द बॉयंट फोर्स देन बॉडी विल सिंक। इफ द वेट ऑफ द बॉडी विल इक्वल टू द बॉयंट फोर्स देन बॉडी विल फ्लोट नेक टू नेक। एंड थर्ड इज इफ वेट ऑफ द बॉडी इज लेस देन द बॉयंट फोर्स देन बॉडी विल फ्लोट। Now, today, we are going to discuss about the special features of floating body. First is, floating body is a weightless body. We know that at the time of floating, weight of the body will be equal to the buoyant force. At the time of floating, weight of the body equal to the weight of the displaced liquid. Displaced liquid means कि जितना वो partially उसमें dip करती है, जो part उसका liquid के अंदर होता है उससे जितना liquid वो displace कर रही है उस liquid का weight जो होता है that will be equal to the weight of the body. So that if we check the weight of the body by the balance, by the spring balance in the floating condition, it will be equal to zero because weight of the body is in downward direction and upward thrust, that is buoyant force, up thrust हम बोल सकते हैं इसको, it is in upward direction. At the time of floating, weight of the body is downward, W is equal to mg, and up thrust equal to the weight of the displaced liquid. Both are equal and opposite, so apparent weight will be zero. Apparent weight of the body equal to zero. That's why the body is said to be in weightlessness condition. That's why floating body is a weightless body. Next topic is, loss of weight of a floating body is complete. Loss of weight of a floating body is complete. If the floating body is weightless, it means it has lost its weight completely. We know that floating body is weightless. It means it has lost its weight completely. So that loss of weight for a floating body is equal to real weight minus apparent weight. It is equal to zero. Loss of weight for a floating body equal to real weight minus apparent weight. So we can write loss of weight for a floating body is equal to real weight minus apparent weight is zero at the time of floating, so it is equal to real weight. It means loss of weight for a floating body will be equal to real weight. It means body lost the weight complete. Next topic is, relation between density of solid and liquid. Third point is, relation between density of solid and liquid. We know that weight of the floating solid, weight of the floating solid is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. Let V1 is the volume of solid, Rho1 is the density, then weight will be V1, Rho1 and G. We know that V1 and Rho1 will be equal to mass, volume and density will be equal to mass, and mass into g will be the weight of the floating body. सिमिलरली V2 इज द डिस्प्लेस्ड वॉल्यूम ऑफ डिस्प्लेस्ड वाटर, Rho2 इज डेंसिटी ऑफ डिस्प्लेस्ड वाटर और लिक्विड एंड G, देन वी नो दैट G क्रॉस बाय G, देन V1 Rho1 इज इक्वल टू V2 Rho2. Here V1 is the volume of the solid, Rho1 is density, and V2 is the volume of the displaced liquid, and Rho2 is the density of liquid. Then the ratio of density, Rho1 upon Rho2, will be equal to V2 upon V1. It means the density of solid upon density of liquid will be equal to volume of the immersed portion of the solid, volume of dipped portion of solid upon total volume of solid, or we can say the ratio of density Rho1 and Rho2 will be equal to the fraction of volume of body immersed in the liquid. Fraction of volume of body immersed in the liquid. Now come to the numerical. The volume of a solid of mass 500 gram is 350 centimeter cube. The volume of a solid of mass 500 gram is 350 centimeter cube. What will be the density of this solid? Density of this solid. What will be the relative density of solid? Third is, will it float or sink in water? And fourth is, what will be the mass of water displaced by this solid? Of water displaced by this solid. This is the question. Now solution is density of solid, first part is equal to mass of solid upon volume of solid. Mass is given 500 gram and volume is 350. That is equal to 1.42 gram per centimeter cube. Relative density, second part, density of solid, density of water, the ratio of density of solid upon density of water, it will be 1.42 upon density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube hota hai. It is gram per centimeter cube also. It will be 1.42. It is unitless because it is relative density. And see, third part is, since the relative density of this solid is 1.42 is greater than the relative density of water, which is 1. So it will sink in the water. We know that 1.42 is greater than 1. The density of solid is greater than the density of water, then it will be sink. And the fourth part, you have to find what will be the mass of water displaced by this solid. We know that the density of water is, density of water is equal to mass of water, volume of water. We know that it is given, it is 1 gram per centimeter cube. The mass of water to be find, and volume of water is given, because body will sink completely, so volume of the body will be equal to the volume of displaced water. So we can write here 350 gram per centimeter cube. Do you understand it? It is given the volume of the body is 350 centimeter cube, and वी फाइंड हियर द बॉडी इज कम्प्लीटली सिंक बिकॉज इट्स डेंसिटी इज ग्रेटर देन द वाटर डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर सो इट डिस्प्लेस द वॉल्यूम इक्वल टू इट्स वॉल्यूम सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ द वाटर विल बी 350 वॉल्यूम ऑफ द डिस्प्लेस वाटर इज 350 सो दैट मास इज इक्वल टू 350 इंटू 1 दैट इज इक्वल टू 350 ग्राम्स एम इज दिस इज द आंसर